Shevchenko is there early.
You see, right off the bat, we saw Grasso come out southpaw in the first fight. She comes.
Shevchenko able to land a left on the end of that combination. Grasso now lands.
And the stance switch out of Grasso has taken away that back leg kick of Shevchenko that she was able to land very fast. Now that she switched stance, that kick isn't there, and it forces Shevchenko to adjust, start using that jab.
You saw Valentina step there and look like she was trying to spin.
She's looking for that hook. And the hook sets up that spin attack.
Look, Valentina start tripping here.
Nice takedown. Dumping to see if Valentina can transition and finish this.
Wow. She got home.
And the scramble. And that's what we saw.
The body by Shevchenko, but beautifully defended by the Mexican Grasso.
And that's what I said is going to be one of the keys through the whole fight, is if Grasso can create the space after she does get taken down. She got taken down in the last fight, but if you watch in her results in past fights, she always.
All right, Valentina Shevchenko with a takedown, but a competitive round one.
That takedown by Valentina, the first one was defended, the second one when she was able to get to the body, she was able to complete fairly easy. So it leads you to believe that she's gonna go there again. You just wonder how soon she's gonna try as Alexa lands a nice combo. She was just wrestling to dominate her on the ground. We have seen her do a tremendous job of controlling women on the mat.
Oh, loser! Grasso!
Nice. Tight waist again. Body lock is deep. Let's see if she can finish it. That is tight. That's a bear hug, you call that.
Yeah,
she gets out.
Grasso did a great job re-gripping the lock.
Elbow. Space won't be Grasso's friend.
No, Grasso's corner's telling her to calm down.
This is not a territory that Shevchenko's used to being in either. Nice double.
Oh, nice double.
Beautiful
there.
Timing.
Great timing there by the former champion.
That's smart. That was exactly what she needed. Exactly what she needed.
And it was because Grasso got
that floored Shevchenko. Still just over 2 minutes here, round two.
And they both traded. They both connected. Just that you're seeing the power difference with Grasso.
We have seen Alexa Grasso just mature over the course of her UFC career. For a long time, she was killing herself to get down to 115, but the moment she went to 125, she was a completely different fighter, and now she finds herself the champion. Will really serve her well as we get to the end of the round.
Yeah, that knockdown's the round, at least right now, under 90 seconds to go.
Ooh,
a kick from Grasso. Well, these women certainly bringing out the best in each other. Oh, comfortable as a grappler off of her back. Diego Lopez certainly deserves a lot of credit. Good left hand.
Tina loses this round. This is exactly what she needed. She needs to reset the fight because Alexa Grasso is starting to build momentum.
We got a round. Here we go at the beginning of round three. Grasso, the slight favorite on the live number.
But you see Grasso go back to conventional. Look for Valentina to start to throw that body kick again.
Oh, yeah, she's looking for it right now. That's her. That's how she finds her range, Valentina. She lands that kick and then starts getting to work from there. But the stance switch, you could tell, kind of offsets the rhythm, the timing.
Inside leg kick lands cleanly for Shevchenko. Grasso corner calling for more feints out of her.
Nice double. She drove her feet, she didn't stop on her knees, and she turned the corner. I mean, that's exactly how you finish a double leg. Drive your feet, turn the corner, perfect.
Grasso had an underhook. She was able to get her hands between Shevchenko and her legs.
Nice job.
That was great by Herb Dean. Didn't rush, didn't panic.
And a great job by Grasso to stay composed.
She never looked lost in there.
Two minutes to go in round three.
She's got the foot on the floor now. That's exactly what she's got to do with that lock to get out of this body triangle. See how that foot is on the floor of Shevchenko. Yep. She wants to step over the top of that lead leg of Shevchenko, which she has. Start cranking on that ankle. And then slide her back to the mat. Grasso wants to get her head and her right shoulder flat on the mat. Now she's turning her hip down. She wants to go the other way. There, like that. Does she get underneath
it? Yes. She's got to find a way to clear that.
She's going the wrong way.
Well, she's trying to just twist. But Valentina's just controlling. She's not allowing for the body triangle to break.
Yeah, you got to go the other way.
Well, she'll end up on top.
For Shevchenko. There it is. Great finish to the round.
Big round three, though, for the former champ.
Three to Shevchenko, round two to the champion, Grasso. But this is where Grasso's got to be very careful in her approach. She cannot get reckless and get taken down early in this round.
Keep stepping forward and throwing punches. Then she can find her range.
She ate a couple shots trying to get inside there. Shevchenko has landed 54% of her significant strikes thus far. 42% for Grasso.
Nice double. Great spell. See what she can do with this front headlock.
Hey. The hands up.
Yep.
Yeah, she was moving her back, so those were legal because she was dragging her backwards and the hand was coming up while she was moving. You can't touch the hand on the floor to stop them from kneeing you. You have to have weight on the hand in order for it to be a good stop.
Big knee to the body by Grasso. Shevchenko briefly protested those knees to the head.
The refs tell you in the back, you have to have weight on the hand. She scrambles. She's got an armbar transition here that she can transition from the Kimura.
She
can
got
take
excited.
The back or go to the arm.
She got excited.
The replay did confirm that all of those strikes were legal. One hand down does not constitute a grounded opponent here under the guise of the Nevada State Athletic Commission. Good elbow from Shevchenko. Grasso's got to get back to the volume game. 1 minute to go, round four. Combination and the right lands for Shevchenko. She has been sharp from the outset.
Another takedown on the trip. Yep.
Yes, so nice. That's what, four of those, just like that.
Yep, but she kept the wizard this time down.
This is what Grasso has done so well, though, is just escape. She'll let you have a takedown, but she's so hard to hold down and keep there. Other than that round, heel hook's locked in. That's threatening. That's a dangerous situation right here for Shevchenko.
20 minutes down. Shevchenko 4-for-6 on her takedowns thus far. Beautiful jab.
Yeah, that jab has been nice tonight for Valentina. She's done a really good job of popping that jab, and then when Alexa gets close, she takes her down.
Both fighters landed there, but a punctuating elbow for Shevchenko.
Big cut, big takedown, or big knockdown wins the fight, I think, here. Any of those three things.
Or Valentina.
Yeah, she's just a little lighter on her feet, Shevchenko. Just a little lighter, a little quicker,
jab
and getting
sick.
Off a little bit more combos. Mostly the jab, though.
Grasso corner getting progressively more urgent. They need her to get inside.
Well, you see Shevchenko ready to level change the moment Grasso attacks.
Nice three-punch combo there.
Yeah, Shevchenko's fighting a beautiful round.
Yeah, this is a good round right here.
And Grasso is wearing it. A lot of that damage inflicted by that Shevchenko jab. Grasso back to the orthodox stance.
We're going to see Grasso step into the pocket at the end of this round. Nice read by Shevchenko. Gives it back again. Went for a headlock and gave her back. Let's see if she can get out of this. If she can escape, but right now she's giving it up. If she doesn't get moving.
This changes everything.
Wow.
And Valentina has to make sure she doesn't have memories of last time.
Grasso. Late crank attempt here by Grasso. What a fight to put a capstone on the inaugural Noche UFC. Alexa Grasso and Valentina Shevchenko go the 25-minute
This bout is considered a split draw. And still,